horizontal line of 80 mm draw horizontal line of 80 mm So I have drawn first base of 80 mm. Then using the Affiker method, draw its perpendicular bisector. Use your compass. Take the radius approximately half of the given length. Okay, so draw its perpendicular bisector. Okay, then given the height is 60 mm, so mark this 60 mm here. I am writing dimension for your understanding, but don't write dimension like this one. Okay, so first we have marked the base 80 mm, then we have drawn its perpendicular bisector and marked the height 60 mm. Next step, complete a rectangle whose base is 80 mm and height is 60 mm. So what we have to do, through A, draw a vertical line equal to the given height. Through point B, draw a vertical line, okay, and join this point . So what we have done, we have completed a rectangle whose sides are equal to the given base length and height length, that is the axis length. Okay. So I have completed a rectangle of a given base length and height length. Okay. Now next step. Divide. Now mark this. Suppose mark this point A, B, C, D. Okay, and suppose mark this middle height also M and N. Now remember, or if you want to write down the procedure, divide length AM and AD. Divide length AM and AD into same number of equal parts. See, which length I have taken? Half of the given base AM and vertical height AD. Using the graphical method, divide this AM and AD into same number of equal part. So I am dividing this into suppose three part. So we know the graphical method. Through point B, draw vertical line. Mark three equal part of a known length. Join the end point. Then through each point, draw a line parallel to first one. So we have divided this length into three parts. Similarly, divide this length AM also into three equal parts. Through M, again follow the same procedure. Through point M, draw inclined line. Mark three equal part. Okay, here you have to use the roller scale. Okay. So what I have done, I have divided length AM and AD into three equal parts. Then, see the sequence. I am giving the names to this point. Suppose I have marked this point 1, 2. Okay. To avoid the confusion, I am erasing some construction part. And mark this point as a 1-2. So see here, these are the points 1, 2 on the M and on the AD 1-2. Okay. Now through point 1, draw a vertical line. See here. Through point 1, I have drawn a vertical line and take this point N. Join N with 1-. Where both lines are intersecting, mark this point as a P1. Similarly, find out next point. Through point D, through point 2, draw a vertical line. Through point M, join 2-. Where both lines are intersecting, mark this next point. So we have completed half part of the curve. Already A point, it is given. P1 we have found out, P2 we have found out, and this point, given point. So we have completed half part of the curve. Now for remaining part, either follow the same procedure or you can use the property of parabola, that is, it is symmetrical about this vertical axis. Okay, but for your understanding, I am repeating this procedure. Again, I will divide this. Now, remaining part is divide BM and BC into same number of equal parts. Then join the end point. Then through each point, draw the line parallel to first one. Similarly for the length BC also. Join end point. Then through each point, draw the line parallel to first one. Give some length. Suppose mark point 3 here, mark point 4 here. So this will be 3-4-. Then through point 3, draw a vertical line, then join N with 3-. Where both lines are intersecting, mark this point P3. Then through point 4, join a vertical line. Through point N, join 4-, where both lines are intersecting, mark point P4. Okay. So I have completed half part of the curve also. Okay. Then join all these points with a smooth curve. So this is our parabola. So it is a simple method. So this is called a rectangle method.